Good morning and welcome to St. Agnes. Today we celebrate the second Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our readings can be found in the back of the hymnal, number 1112. Our entrance hymn is number 607, All Creatures of Our God and King, number 607.
Creatures of our God and King, lift up your voice and with us sing. Alleluia, alleluia. O burning sun with golden beam and silver moon with softer gleam, sing your praises. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. O rushing wind and breezes soft, O clouds that ride the winds aloft, sing your praises. Alleluia, O rising morn in praise rejoice, O lights of evening find a voice, sing your praises, alleluia.
Let us begin by calling upon God as Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
May the grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us pause for a moment and consider how we stand before God and one another. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God Almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in the glory of God. of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty and never-living God, who govern all things both in heaven and on earth, mercifully hear the pleading of your people. Bestow peace on our times. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord said to me, "You are my servant, Israel, through whom I show my glory. Now the Lord has spoken, who formed me as his servant from the womb, that Jacob may be brought back to him, and Israel gathered to him. And I am made glorious in the sight of the Lord, and my God is now my strength. It is too little, the Lord says, for you to be my servant, to raise up the tribes of Jacob and restore the survivors of Israel. I will make you a light to the nations, that my salvation may reach to the ends of the earth." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Come to do your will. Here am I, Lord, I come to do your will. I waited for the Lord, and he stooped down to me, he heard my cry. He put a new song into my mouth, praise of our God. Here am I, Lord, I come to do delight not in sacrifice and offerings, but in an open ear. You do not ask for holocaust and victim. Then said I, "See, I have come." Here am I, Lord, I come to do your will. In the scroll of the book it stands written of me, I delight to do your will, O my God. Your instruction lies deep within me. Here am I, Lord, I come to do your will. Your justice I have proclaimed in the great assembly. My lips I have not sealed, you know it, O Lord. Here am I, Lord, I come to do your will.
reading from the beginning of the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Paul, called to be an apostle of Christ Jesus by the will of God, and Sosthenes, our brother, to the church of God that is in Corinth, to you who have been sanctified in Christ Jesus, called to be holy, with all those everywhere who call upon the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, their Lord and ours. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Accepted him, he gave power to become children of God. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
John the Baptist saw Jesus coming toward him and said, "Behold, the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. He is the one of whom I said, 'A man is coming after me who ranks ahead of me because he existed before me.' I did not know him, but the reason why I came baptizing with water was that he might be made known to Israel." John testified further, saying, "I saw the Spirit come down like a dove from heaven and remain upon him. I did not know him, but the one who sent me to baptize with water told me, 'On whomever you see the Spirit come down and remain, he is the one who will baptize with the Holy Spirit.' Now I have seen and testified that he is the Son of God." The Gospel of the Lord. In our reading from St. Paul this morning, he challenges us. You have been sanctified in Christ Jesus. You have been called to be holy. I very much enjoy preaching on this passage from St. Paul. The spirituality of St. Francis de Sales fits so beautifully as an expression of what St. Paul is telling us in his letter to the Corinthians. Francis believed that all people are called to be holy. All people are called to be saints. And so in his famous book, The Introduction to the Devout Life, Francis wrote, "When he created things, God commanded plants to bring forth their fruits, each one according to its kind. In like manner, God commands Christians, the living plants of the church, to bring forth the fruits of holiness, each according to one's position and vocation." End quote. Striving for perfection, growing in holiness. As Francis writes, "Vive Jesu," to live Jesus Christ, is a formidable challenge. Embracing a life of virtue requires strength and courage. Renouncing sin requires strength and virtue. Turning a deaf ear to temptation requires strength and courage. And on any given day, our progress in devotion is marked both by many successes and some setbacks. However, striving to be holy is made even more difficult when we attempt to be holy in a way that does not fit our state or stage in life, a way of living that does not fit who we are. I repeat that. The striving to be holy is made even more difficult when we attempt to be holy in a way that does not fit our state or stage in life, a way of living that does not fit who we are. St. Francis de Sales reminds us as he writes, devotion and holiness must be exercised in different ways by the gentleman, the worker, the servant, the prince, and the widow, the young girl, the married woman. I ask you, is it fitting for a bishop to want to live a solitary life like a monk? Or for a married man to want to own no more property than a monk? For a skilled workman to spend his whole day in church? Would not such holiness be laughable, confused, and impossible to live? Francis then puts it another way when he said, some of the saints excelled in one virtue, some excelled in another, and although all have saved their souls, they have done so in very different ways, there being as many different kinds of sanctity as there are saints. Oh, to be sure, if there is one model of Christian life, it is Jesus Christ, the one in whom all of us are created. But to be holy is not about trying to be like someone else. Rather, being holy is about having the strength, the integrity, and the courage to be who and how God wants each one of us to be, precisely in the places, the circumstances, and the relationships in which we find ourselves day after day. Doing what you're responsible for doing in your state in life, however complex that may be, however simple that may be, but doing them well, doing them completely, and doing them for the love of God is our path for holiness. And if we do this, Francis de Sales tells us, if we commit ourselves to acting completely, acting well, and acting in a way that glorifies God, we are on the road to holiness. And may God continue to bless you on that road to holiness as Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Having heard God's word and having reflected upon what that word means in our lives, let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pause now as we place our petitions before the throne of God.
For all of our church leaders, especially Pope Francis, Bishop Burbage, and our parish priests, that they will preach the gospel with courage and conviction, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our nation, that together we will promote the common good of all, safeguard the sanctity of marriage and the family, and defend the rights to life and to religious freedom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For justice, security, and peace among nations, and for those who serve in our law enforcement, military, intelligence, and diplomatic services to make peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the end of war in Ukraine, the withdrawal of Russia, and the restoration of justice and peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Christians who face persecution and genocide, especially in communist and Islamic countries, that the Holy Spirit will keep them strong in the faith, and for all non-believers, that the Holy Spirit will move them to faith in our divine Savior, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the acceptance of vocations to the priesthood and religious life, that young men and women from our own families will heed Christ's call and offer their lives to Him who gave His life for us, and for our parish seminarians, Deacon Tony Bennett, Deacon Mike Nugent, James Joseph, Gabriel Godet, Michael Gibbons, and John Anthony Buono, and for Sister Monica Baptiste Whalen and Sister Abigail Therese Jones, novices for the Dominican Sisters in Nashville, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and homebound and for our deceased, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Bob Whitney, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our own personal intentions held in the quiet of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Almighty Father, we come before you this morning with our prayers and petitions. We ask you to hear the petitions which we have spoken aloud, and all the prayers and petitions each of us holds in our hearts. We place them before you in the name of Christ Jesus, your Son. Amen.
Our offertory hymn is number 458, When John Baptized by Jordan's River, number 458. Father's word was spoken,
not in the power of wind and flame, but of his love and peace the token, seen as a dove the Spirit King.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the cause of his church.
Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries. For whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy,
indeed, holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray the partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Michael, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen.
Jesus taught us to call God our Father, and so we have the courage to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and power and glory are yours, now.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to one another a sign of Christ's peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Thank you, have mercy, eat your body and drink your blood. Let not bring me condemnation, but health and mind and body. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
I, the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry, oh, dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make the darkness bright. Oh, he'll bear my light to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart. I, the Lord of snow and rain, I have borne my people's pain. I have wept for love of them, they turn away. I will break their hearts of stone, give them hearts for love alone. I will speak my word to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart. I, the Lord of wind and flame, I will tend the poor and lame. I will set a feast for them, my hand will save. Finest bread I will provide, till the hearts be satisfied. I will give my life to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart.
Our poor box collection this weekend is for the Poor Clares, a cloistered community of sisters in Alexandria who depend on others for their support. Friday, January 20th is the annual March for Life. You're welcome to join the parish group. Please see the bulletin for details. Monday is Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. federal holiday. The parish offices will be closed and Mass will be offered at 9 a.m. only. Let us pray. Pour on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness make those you have nourished by this one heavenly bread, one in mind and in heart. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God. Our recessional hymn is number 636. Let all things now living, number 636.
Let all things now living, a song of thanksgiving to God the Creator, triumphantly raise. Who fashioned and made us, protected and stayed us, and guides us with care to the end of our days. God's banners are us, God's light goes before us, a pillar of fire shining forth in the night. Till shadows have vanished and darkness is banished, as forward we travel from light into light. God rules all the forces, the stars in their courses, and sun in its orbit obediently shine. The hills and the mountains, the rivers and fountains, the deeps of the ocean proclaim God divine. We too should be voicing our love and rejoicing with glad adoration. A song let us raise till all things now living unite in thanksgiving to God in the highest. Hosanna and